that in mind right there. If you guys notice, my thumb is never in there. That's how we do it. Yeah?
So talking about the tools now, I'm going to talk about the tools that we use for color. Our tin comb and our highlighting comb. These are going to become your best friends. You can never put them down. Right, when I teach classes, that's what I've seen. A lot of people that what they do, they do something and they put their comb down. They do something and they put their comb down. Right? So this, the comb is always going to be in your hand. You're never going to put it down. Lo que estoy diciendo, hablando de los instrumentos que usamos, este es el instrumento que usamos para hacer highlights y para aplicar el tinte. Y estos van a ser sus mejores amigos, no lo van a poder poner para abajo. Porque es muy esencial que los tengan siempre a mano. Ahora, quiero que se fijen también en las brochas que usamos. El tamaño de la brocha es muy importante para el detalle. Porque si usamos brochas grandes, no tendríamos el mismo control. Así que es muy esencial que usemos este tamaño de brochas. No sé si quieren que las pase para que las vean, que vean el tamaño, también lo que usemos, el aluminio, lo doblamos en una de las What we do with our foils as well, we just fold the very end, one of the ends, like twice wide, just to give us a stability. Because we don't use our comb to place our foil. We place it straight on without using the tail comb. Yeah?
Yes. Even if we're doing it all over color, all the time, is the brush that we use.
I've messed around with this, and this is it a time thing?
So you know the color, it has a longevity, so it's going to stop working. It really depends how deep you want it to be.
Because I noticed that when I did it, it turned the color, but then I left it long and it was dark.
Did you do it on straight line hair or on just...
I just slapped it on.
Yeah, but was it like straight line hair, natural hair, or colored hair?
It was colored hair.
Alright, so colored hair, you know the color is not going to remove color. It's not going to do nothing to it. So that's something you always have to put in mind. Now, because if it was natural color, it will still try to let it penetrate, but if it has color, it's not going to do anything to it. Now, if it's pre-line color, you're going to see it's a beautiful shade. That's one of my favorites at the moment, that purple. So you guys are going to be able to see that. So when you apply your sections or your slices, you grab a very small section of your hair. Very, very fine.
Las sesiones que están haciendo las tres son sesiones bastante finas para lo que voy a hacer ahora.
That's the purple.
And this is the purple. So it's just like do like very, very thorough in the hair, going back and forth. Being generous with it, so it's a nice application, and it comes with nice even coloration in the hair. You don't want it just to do it on one side, you can do it back and forth, just to, so it's a nice saturated color.